So today I decided to read one of my stories. I post them on my blog, mariebonnet.com, and I decided to read some of them. Not everybody can read, so I am going to read that for you. Okay, so here we go. Let's just pause here for a minute while I do this and get ready. So, the story is called The Walls to the Pyramids. It is hot, the sky a crisp blue with not one cloud. The rusty desert sands feel surreal. We ride our bikes through a road of beaten red dirt, all the way to what appears to be a bus shelter made of red bricks. As we park our bikes, I have this strangest sensation. I know my family's there with me. They had been riding with me. However, I cannot quite focus on them. I'm barely aware of them. Looking far out into the horizon, I can see the pyramids, the imposing stone structures poke the skies, enticing my curiosity and my sense of adventure. I want to go there. I long to touch them, to go inside. I have wanted this for so long. My eyes blur with the blowing sand. Everything appears to fade out and back in. Once again, that surreal feeling invades my senses. I disconnect from everything else around me as if spirited away to an alternate reality. It is like an out-of-body experience, as if my mind's eye is seeing everything from a 45 degree above the ground. As I focus, I see structures that rise from the ground leading to the pyramids. I realize they are like tall, solid white brick walls, seven walls to be precise. I realize then that to get to the pyramids, I will have to climb each one of them. However, I am vested with newfound determination. I begin my journey. I start climbing. I carry nothing with me, just the clothes of my body. My parents and my brother stay behind to wait at the shelter. I climb each wall with my bare hands. It takes great effort, but I am determined. I need to get there. Finally, the last wall. I climb down impatiently and come face to face with this impressive structure in front of me. I'm awestricken, excited, and very much impulsively, I enter the pyramid. I stop and look at what's in front of me. Suddenly, I am filled with unexpected emotions like puzzlement, surprise, and disappointment. The pyramid's interior does not look at all like I thought it should. It is like looking at a small lobby in a rustic hotel, you know, with a mix of modern metal frame chairs and red brick walls and a check-in area also made of bricks with dark wood countertop. There is a man behind the counter. I can only see from his waist up. His hands are resting flat on the counter in front of him. He's obese, bald, and is wearing an old-fashioned light blue suit. His almond-shaped eyes are blue and emanate evil. I am now feeling a bit anxious, frightened. With a sneer on his thin lips, he says, "So, you were curious." His tone is low and deep, his cadence slow, precise, and threatening. You wanted to come inside. Fine. He produces a half smile that never reaches his eyes. Go on, he says, pointing to a doorway to his left. Despite the eerie feeling I now have, I move toward the passageway. As soon as I pass through it, I find myself in a dark and humid area with walls and floor made of large stones. The humidity is unbearable. I can feel the moss on the walls. I now also see stairs going down. I start climbing down the creepy stairway, trying to hold on to the cold walls and trying to adjust my eyes to the darkness. I come to a landing. I see the stairwell continues down, but there is a door here. A door made of large old planks of dark wood and wrought iron handle, like a shape of a ring. I decide to open it before continuing down the steps. Hesitantly, I open the door. As I enter, in total horror, I see this is a dungeon with the skeletons of those who must once have been prisoners, with their wrists still shackled to the walls. It smells dampness, smell of death. Yet, as inconceivable as it may be, I get out of there and decide to venture down the steps to the next level. There, I encounter the same horrific view. Completely horrified, I finally climb up the stairways, two steps at a time, as fast as I possibly can. The fat man is still there with the same evil sneer. I don't stop. I run. I run away from the pyramid. I am so distraught. I need to go back to my family at the shelter. Oh God, I think I'll have to climb all those walls again. I have no choice. I have to go. I climb all seven walls rapidly and dexterously, desperately wanting to leave behind the horror I have just seen. Suddenly, I become disconnected again, this out-of-body feeling, and see myself climbing the last walls. I am back at the bike shelter. All the bikes are there, but I am alone. My parents, my brother, they're all gone. I am invaded by a profound sense of sadness and melancholy. I look out to the rusty desert sands. The horizon seems so much farther away than before. The pyramids are there, the walls too, but so far away. And I am alone. The wind blows the sand, making everything hazy. And then I wake up. There you have it. The end. I hope you enjoyed this story. This is the first time I do one of my stories like this, like a, what do they call it? A vlog, right? So yeah, I hope you liked it. And I'm going to take a look and see how it sounds. And if I like it a little bit, I'll post it. But if I hate it, I won't. Bye.